Hello YouTube, Beanie from the bedroom here. So I'm gonna fire up this here Prince caster. Yeah. But before I do that, and I speak afterwards, these are the pickups. And that's running it, you know, it's the chorus, like I said, is on all the time, but the rate is at zero and the depth is at like 1-2 o'clock. And a bit of slapback. And that's just going through the Marshall amp with said guitar with original pickups. These are even the original strings on this guitar. Now, when I hit the boost on the Demon FX, you hear that grit? That's like a great late 60s, you know, kind of distortion overdrive for a Telecaster. I turn that off and hit the OD overdrive on it. And it thickens it up. Yeah. So, to make it sound like a true Telecaster, let's run it with the OD. Sorry, the boost. See what we got. Can't even hear my playing because I've got the amp so loud, and that's because I actually did a sound check this time, and when I just did a boom, doo, 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 I played it back, and wow, the guitar was screaming. You could barely hear it. Now I've got the amp cranked up for this backing track, and it's blasting in my ear. I can't even really hear what I'm playing. So, you know, let's talk about this here puppy. This is probably the best guitar I've ever gotten. One of two great guitars I've ever bought off of Amazon. And this is the Zoe. And Amazon doesn't sell it anymore. I got this for $260 and it came with it. A little practice amp that sounded pretty cool, but I gave it away. And a bunch of stuff, cables and picks and strings. And you know, this here and the IYV that I got, that's the Paul Reed Smith copycat. The two only guitars that I've ever kept from Amazon, and two of the best guitars I've ever gotten from Amazon. Now, you could buy this, I believe, on eBay or Reverb. That's about it. Or you can go to their website. Although I did see these exactly without the Zoe brand, with the copycat brand, what is it, Mad Cats, on AliExpress for about the same price. Some of them have it with free shipping, some of them have it where you pay $18 for shipping. But I think they're all coming from the same place. So it's got the plastic black plate in between the bolt-on plate for the neck. But look at that tiger maple front and back. You know, original tuners, I haven't touched them, and I don't think I will. I think I'll just try to, when I do finally change them, because I've had this guitar for at least a couple of years now. It's still the same strings, and they're not even tarnished. And I leave this out. I'll leave this hanging on the wall constantly. I don't play it all that much, but I just love looking at it. The only thing that I can say about this is probably the one guitar I have with the fattest neck on it. Now, don't get me wrong, this is not a super fat, chunky neck. I think it's not equivalent to a Joe Perry neck or Zakk Wylde. I had a Zakk Wylde guitar, and that neck was beefy, boy. It was like a baseball bat. This is just slightly fatter than all my other necks on all my other guitars, and I'm going from anywhere from the Ibanez that I had. Scratch the Ibanez, because they were like wizard. The Schecter. Schecter has a nice wizard thin kind of neck on it, but it's not super thin like an Ibanez. And all the Holly Bentons that I have a great, thin, like, you know, 60s neck on it. This is just a slightly fatter. And after playing those all the time, as soon as I pick it up, I notice it right away. But it doesn't make me play any worse. It just gives me more meat, you know. Where if I was doing chords, maybe it would... Not even that, but, you know, I don't even know what chords I'm doing at the time when I'm doing it, but no, it just feels a little bit fatter than what I normally am used to. Did I make sense on that? And this has some dust on it, and I feel bad that I didn't dust it off before I viewed it. But someone had asked me about this, you know, recently, last night, how much does it weigh? And I think I said 7 pounds, but it feels like, yeah, like a 7 pounds max. This is my scale on. But still, you know, even if I didn't have that, if I had seen the copy of the Mad Cats, and I think it's a copy because it's coming from AliExpress. I think anything that comes from AliExpress isn't the true brand name. But they still have the Mad Cats name, just like the real Prince guitar. You know, That looks just as cool. It looks like it's a glossy finish like this, and glossy neck. So I believe all of these are made in the same factory. You know, you know, anything that I could say about this guitar, that if I were to restring it, I think I would cut a square notch here so I can get to the truss rod, because that's filled in and that's the only place to get to it. This way I wouldn't have to remove the strings or remove the pickguard. So I think if I ever do change the strings, I might just leave the tuners, you know, maybe not, because I don't like the wind strings, but I would do some kind of a notch here for that. But a couple of years I've had it here in Florida, hanging up on the wall. I haven't had to do anything with it, really. Basically took it out of the box and tuned it up, and that's it. I didn't do anything of an adjustment, a setup. I didn't have to touch the saddles. It's tuned to an E, and intonation on the 12th fret is to an E. And I have no issues with the neck. The neck is actually exactly where I want it, where it's not super low, the strings, but just enough where when I bend, my fingers aren't rolling over the strings, but aren't going under the strings, if you know what I'm saying. When I bend the string, my finger on the string I'm bending actually pushes the top string out of the way. It's not going over it, it's not going under it, you know. So yeah, so I just did another recap on this for because I've had maybe three or four people ask me about this guitar, and I just had one ask me last night, so I figured let me just do a quick thing on it. And you could hear it, these are factory pickups, and I don't think they're anything special. They're not the best pickups in the world, but they're not the worst. They're not microphonic, and they do the job. So you know, if I don't even find a need to switch those out, just like I don't find a need to switch the tuners out. Just, I don't like to, who likes to sit there and crank and wrap a string and try to tie a knot and all that hoopla, right? I don't. All right, thanks YouTube for watching. Have a good day, better tomorrow.